Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Ask Dr. Bob. A lot of different questions today. Question number one, Dr. Bob had been watching you for several months. Enjoy the information. But you have a question about your finger. It swells, especially during hot weather. You mentioned you're 32 years old, have a history of hyperparathyroid, take a lot of vitamin D every week, and you have occasional reactions to hot weather. What we have seen traditionally is hot weather tends to bother people who have thyroid issues. Now, the parathyroid has everything to do with calcium absorption. Instead of taking copious amounts of vitamin D, I would encourage you to have your vitamin D tested and treat that accordingly. And I'd also have your thyroid gland tested because you may be creating some distress and you might need some calcium. So I just thought I would throw that out. Have your vitamin D tested. Another individual has a 13-year-old with some emotional and self-harming challenges and psychiatric difficulties and wanted to know what supplements we would suggest. Well, first thing I would suggest is having an essential fatty acid blood spot test done. That'll tell us the levels of oil, because I know there's a long-chain fatty acid in the brain called DHA, docosahexaenoic acid, that tends to be low or substandard in individuals with emotional distress. That's one of the reasons I wrote Dr. Bob's Guide to Stop ADHD in 18 Days. The essential fatty acid blood spot test would tell me what oil this individual needs, but inositol is a product that we use from Biotic Research Corporation that helps individuals with OCD, and also we use sometimes a product called L-Lysine, which is a vegetable-based lithium for people who have those type of emotional disorders. Next question, Dr. Bob, I crave sweets, and I also have some immune issues. Well, here's what I would encourage you to do. We use a product that has chromium in it. Chromium anywhere from 4 to 6 a day until your sugar cravings would go away. As a regard to your immune system, they wanted to know about the flu shot because I think there are family members that want you to have that. Well, I don't use the flu shot. I'm 60 years old. I haven't had the flu since I was in the third grade back in 1961 or 62. We encourage our practice members to avoid sugar, and you want to be taking some vitamin D. Vitamin D improves the white blood cells in your body, the phagocytosis. And we also encourage our practice members to use a product called Agricept L, which is a citric seed extract. But, up to 10 drops a day with that, by the way, but no sugar. Sugar will compromise your system. Dr. Bob, you wanted to know about adrenal glands and dry eyes. What we have found, one of the leading challenges with dry eyes is actually lack of iodine. So we encourage our practice members to take iodine. I know the Japanese women take up to about 12 milligrams of iodine a day, and that's the amount I take. To be very specific on the amount of iodine you need, you might consider a urine iodine loading test. Now, if your adrenal glands are really hyper and you have a sympathetic nervous system response, yes, you possibly could have some dryness, but really we have found great results with iodine. You also wanted to know about candida, and the Agricept L I mentioned earlier will help candida, but there's a tremendous book out there called The Yeast Connection by Dr. William Crooks. I would encourage you to read that book. Stay away from sugar, of course, yeast products, and sweet fruit. Dr. Bob, my dad has terrible pain and bulging in his low back, and you mentioned number 2, 3, and 4, which is, I'm assuming, the lumbar area. But I don't know enough to make any specific challenge or improvements to the challenge. We have found that a lot of chronic low back is because people's heads are forward. So you could work, have your dad work on pulling his body backwards. Of course, he's going to want to have some films done. You may want to find a skilled chiropractor in your area. We do non-cracking type of adjustments in our practice. We see people from all over the United States. No sugar. Bounce on a ball. I bounce on a 65-centimeter ball every day. Dr. Bob, what about drinking water during the meals? We have some friends recently that want to know the source of this information. Well, you're going to get a lot of different opinions about water and digestion. I know that most people don't have enough digestive enzymes in their stomach, especially when they're 40 years or older. So I know that Ayurvedic medicine, which is Indian Asian medicine, also promotes minimal fluids during the meals. I know people who are blood type A should have minimal fluids during the meals. Your goal is drink water before and after meals so you have plenty of saliva to digest that food. And also maybe some sliced cucumbers or some tomatoes with your meal just to give you those natural enzymes. When you drink water, especially if you drink a lot of water with the meal, and for sure never cold water, you will stagnate your digestion. Dr. Bob, my doctor diagnosed me with polycystic ovaries. We have found the best way to remedy polycystic ovaries is with iodine. You may consider a urine iodine loading test. I would not suggest the medications that take away inflammation, get to the root cause, try some iodine. My name is Dr. Bob DiMaria, and thank you once again for Ask Dr. Bob questions.